Hey y'all, welcome to the Suburban Stitcher podcast. My name is Diane, and today is March 7th, 2017. I want to start off by saying happy early birthday, or really, this will probably be up tomorrow, so it'll be perfect. Happy birthday to my mom. I am just always so happy for your birthday, and I love you so much, and I hope you're having a lovely day. I will get to see you this weekend, so happy birthday, Mom! Love you! Mwah. I know she watches faithfully, even though she doesn't knit, and maybe one day, maybe we can get her knitting, right, y'all? But I am here to talk this week mostly about the Hill Country Weavers Knitting in the Hills retreat that I just returned from. I had, as always, the time of my life with the tribe, the knitter tribe, and I am just so excited to be back here talking to you about it. I have pink hair. It's very pink, right? Do you love it? I'm so in love with it. I know you either probably really love it or really hate it because colored hair is very polarizing, but I kind of feel like a hot pink Ariel right now. Also, on a side note, I'm super proud of myself because I can never successfully like curl wave my hair. This was all me. Usually when you see it nice and curly, it's because my hairdresser has done it and I haven't washed it yet. And, or my stylist, excuse me. That's a much fancier word. But she got me a curling iron and I've been practicing in April. It looks so good, right? I think I did pretty good. Okay, so I want to talk a little bit about knitting, just the projects and things that I've been working on. This week and while I was gone, and then I will talk about all of the big hello lovelies from the retreat. Sound good? So I haven't finished anything, which may be the story of my life for a very long time at this point. But last week I mentioned that I was putting in blanket squares of my Deep South Charm on my blanket. And I finished doing that. So I think last week I had azaleas, peach tea, and magnolia. And now I've added Spanish moss, Bourbon Street blues, and haint blue. So all six of the Deep South colors are in there, and really excited about that. So that is just a simple thing that I worked on. I would love to be able to spend more time on my blankets, but that is just not in the cards these days for me. Lost my pillow. Oh well. I feel like I'm a little off center. I'm sort of playing with the light, and now you get to see all of the pile of bags. When you're in a bag maker house, there's always a pile of bags. Anyway, okay, so I brought my snowmelt shawl to the retreat, and I did get a chance to put in some rows on this, and it was perfect because the rows that I were not super complicated. It was just a lot of this looks like garter stitch, really, mainly. So I finally finished Clue 2, which was here and kind of a couple repeats right there, and I'm into Clue 3. I've reintroduced the second color, which is this little bit darker gray. So I've reintroduced it down here, so now I'll be knitting with the dark gray and the multicolored. I am using 3 skeins of yarn. The 2 grays, this kind of very light pale silvery gray, and then this kind of medium gray. These are mine. This is Whisper and Cinder. And then the multicolored is Miracle Gin in Street Graffiti. And all of these are on the same base. It's a 70% superwash merino, 30% silk, single ply fingering weight. Okay, hazards of long hair. It's always in your mouth. And I am absolutely, like I said, I'm absolutely loving knitting it. When I actually get the time to sit down and work on it, I'm loving it. So, a little bit of tea today. It's very overcast and raining and very gross, and it is definitely a tea afternoon. So, every afternoon is a tea afternoon, but it feels extra appropriate today. So that is one thing I worked on. I've got all these bags over here of all the things. Okay, so I brought. Oh, let's show you this first. Okay, so I brought my rainbow long socks, and this was the first thing I finished. I think I finished this the first night on Wednesday. I finished my first rainbow long sock. I don't have a blocker over here, and I'm not gonna get up and get it, but you can see. So here it is. And this is my rainbow long colorway. It is no longer available. It was exclusive in February for the rainbow long, but I'm very pleased with how this turned out. And I have not, I don't think I have. Yeah, no, I have not started the second sock. So again, very typical for me. But I did, the next thing that I worked on at the retreat is I brought this sock to put some stitches in, and I did not a ton, but I did a fair amount. I brought my Hunk of Vernon Love sock and knit on that. Feels like that definitely needs to go with my hair, right? So I think that I was probably around here, maybe there, maybe a little lower. Actually, no, I can feel where the needles had sat in there for a while. I was around here. So thereabouts. And so I knit quite a bit. This was one class worth of knitting, at the retreat. And again, this is my yarn in the Hunk of Vernon Love colorway, which I will have to bring back at some point because it was a super fun colorway. So that is one little thing that I worked on. Kind of felt like I had crafting ADD at the retreat, but I think that's pretty normal. I knew, and I think I mentioned this last time as well. I picked out a shawl that I was going to knit my leftovers after knitting on the blanket squares. I was going to do my Deep South Charm collection and have a shop sample out of some different, those yarns, and then also this sort of neutrally color. It's a one-off. I will not dye this one again. Ooh, big thunder. Can you hear that? So I just had this and I thought, let me use this, use the leftovers of the mini skeins and knit a shawl. I cast on a shawl. I think I talked about it last time, but I could not figure it out. It was, I don't know if it was just me at a retreat. I don't know if it was the pattern. But I just couldn't do it. Like it's not working for me. So I didn't do that one. I looked at several other designs, which was so fun. I sat down, was sort of trying to figure out this that one shawl pattern that I couldn't figure out. And Bristol Ivy, who was one of the teachers at the retreat, came and sat next to me, and I said, "Hey, let's use your brain for a minute." I said, "What? Here's my situation. Do you have any ideas? What should I knit?" And so we were going through her patterns and thinking about other designers' patterns, which it's like crazy fun to sit next to a designer, right? And just go, "Hey, what would you knit with this? Like, what would you do?" And so in the end, after looking at many options and thinking about many things and seeing lots of inspirational shawls while I was at the retreat, I just decided to make up my own thing. Because it's one of those things where I kind of knew what it needed to be in my head, and I was trying to make somebody else's pattern fit into that box. And I've never designed anything. I am not even going to say that this is designing. It is just knitting. So, what I have done so far, I've done one of the colors. I cast on just some ribbing. I mean, this is fingering weight yarn. These are like size 2.5 or size 3 needles. And that was just based on what I had available to me from my needle stash and also what I knew would be a nice gauge without being too holey. So I cast on some ribbing. Hold these so these don't fly off. Cast on some ribbing with the darker color. And then I just changed over to stockinette and I knit a bunch in the round. And I am going back in. You can see I just finished knitting with that this color, and I'm going back in with this dark color again. I'm gonna do some sort of dividing separation thing next. I don't know what that will look like, but we'll find out together, right? So I'm knitting that, and so it's super fun. I think it's gonna be great to show off these mini skeins, and then it'll be just kind of a good base pattern for, in the future, anytime I want to show off something. So I don't know if I'll write it up. Like I said, it's really not necessarily a very fancy pattern or anything. Maybe what I'll do is in the show notes, whenever I finish it, I can just kind of write down my notes. So we'll see. But I'm having fun. It's lots of just plain stockinette knitting, and for times when I'm at practices or in public or doing other things, it's just like a sock. It's just a little bit bigger. So it's perfect, mindless, round and round and round and round and round knitting. So I will have that little gray section, and then the next color that I will put in will be this Bourbon Street Blues, which is pretty fun. And I don't know if this is going to do any pooling or not. It's dyed in a way where it easily could pool, but we'll just have to see how it knits up at that gauge. So that's kind of the fun too, is to see how these colors play together. So I've talked about those. The last thing, actually, no, I have two more things. I cast this on today. This is my Desert Vista Dye Works sock for March. This is Neon Peeps. I remember seeing someone knit this a couple of years ago, and I just thought it was so cute that I had to knit it. So it is a bright neon pink, a bright highlighter yellow, and then this speckled fun confetti stripe in between. So it's just a three-stripe repeat. It's super, super duper duper fun. So that's that. I just started this morning in Bible study. Which I'm sure all the church ladies think that I'm so silly with my knitting and my pink hair, but I love it. That is going. The last thing that I started this week, which I had no business whatsoever starting this project, but I did, and I have to reach over here to get it. It's behind the camera. It is in a bag, another little experimental bag that I made before I went on the trip, and I kind of love it. So it's sort of this big, sort of plushy, buckety bag. So there will be some version of this at DFW as well. But don't you love this fabric, right? Maker? Maker, maker, because we're all makers. So anyway, this whip kind of is, as most of his patterns do, sort of overtake social media and everyone and everything while they're happening. But I had to cast on a marled magic shawl. So if you're not wanting to see how it goes, then I'm sorry, but it's all over my Instagram. So it's funny how I was really into the secrets with Snowmelt, and this one I'm like, whatever, marled. So I started this a couple of days ago. This is the Stephen West mystery, and it's all marled tastic. So you're just holding two skeins of yarn together and knitting. So there's this sort of webby knitting section right there, changing colors. And then there is this part that I'm working on right here that is seed stitch. And I love it. It is crazy. It is so not colors that I would have necessarily ever put together, but I think they look quite nice together. Basically, these tails, it's just kind of crazy. This is definitely one of those that I am throwing caution to the wind and just knitting. What I did is I pulled out, so I had this as a leftover, this sort of this gold color. I had this as something that I had knit a little bit with, a sort of greenish, mossy color. I had this skein of yarn that I won or swapped for something at the yarn swap at ZK last year, and it's kind of got those golds and greens and pinks and purples and lots of colors. So that sort of went together. I knew there was going to have to be some pink and purple in this thing because everything I make has to have pink and purple. So I pulled out this leftover Madeline Tosh lace that I used several years ago. I pulled out this Kirby Werby Orchid Purple that I've used. I have this white Malabrigo sock that was partially used. I wound up this skein from Little Yellow Uke, and it's 100% merino. It's pinks and purples. I put some of this in there. This is some Three Irish Girls Octopus Garden from Good Yarn, Sarasota. And I have three other skeins of yarn that I may or may not use. We'll see. But I've got some Homespun House. I have some Pura Hilados. Is in some pretty peaches and pinks and golds and yellows. And I have a skein of Very Vintage Mustache in a shawl merino only color, which would look good. So I just have lots of yarn choices that I pulled out, and I just figure whatever I'm in the mood to knit next is going to go in it. So that's it. It's super fun. It's super freeing to go into something with no plan and no design and not even a color scheme really, other than it's kind of pinks and purples and whites and yellow and green, which is sort of a lot of colors, but I guess when you repeat it a lot, it all works. But anyway, so that is that. That's how it's looking. And yeah, you can see all the different variegateds in there. Super fun. Super, super, super fun. So that is my Marled Magic, and it's coming along nicely. A couple more days to finish that first clue, and then I'm still on track. He doesn't release the next clue until the 10th. I think that's Friday. Today's Tuesday. So I'm doing pretty good. I need to do a few repeats every night, and I'll be fine. So that is it for Works in Progress. Like I said, no finished objects. Just the works in progress that I knit kind of throughout the week and weekend. And the last part is Hello Lovelies, which is going to be all knitting in the hills. So just to recap my weekend, basically, I left on Wednesday. I went and got my hair done in Wednesday morning, and I just love my time with my April. She is my stylist, and I love her. So I started off on an amazing happy note because she is just one of the happiest people that I know. So that was great. I jumped in the car and drove to Austin to go to the brand new location of Hill Country Weavers, which I picked up this shirt, The House That Y'all Built, which I think is so cute. Suzanne Middlebrook, I believe, has been in business for over 30 years. It's my co-host. Suzanne has been in business for over 30 years. She is just one of the sweetest people you could ever meet. And I just love that. I love that she put that on her shirt, the house that y'all built. What a testament to her and to the community that she's created, of knitters and weavers and fiber enthusiasts, to be in business in this industry for over 30 years as a store, is just kind of amazing. She has expanded from weaving to knitting to spinning to crocheting, anything fiber arts you can find there. The classrooms are amazing. The classes that she holds are amazing. She's been in three different locations. It's unbelievable. I could wax poetic about it. I did a video of my tour. I gave y'all a little tour of the location when I got there. Isn't it stunning? It's just bright and airy and open. So beautiful. So that was a joy to see. While I was there, I picked up three skeins of yarn that I would need for one of my classes that I was taking on the retreat. I got three skeins of, what is this? This is Shelter by Brooklyn Tweed, and I got three different colors. I know one, this one is Soot. It's just a dark gray. This sort of gold color, kind of honey gold color, is called Hayloft. And the third color that I got is this one, Snowbound, and it's just a light gray. And I took Susan B. Anderson's knit class, so I'll show you that now. This was the first class I took. I actually didn't take this till Friday, but we're making some Fair Isle mitts. And it's sort of design yourself. She gave you some ideas for patterns, and she did teach us how to do this braid thing, which I think is totally groovy. I'm loving it. And then everything else, I've just sort of designed, picked out designs that I liked and plugged them in here. So, got this much of a mitt done, which is pretty exciting. More of a mitt than I've ever done. I am doing the size large because I do not have small petite hands, especially with color work. And so I'm right at where I want to be to start increasing for the thumb. So that will happen at some point. Who knows? But I know I need to work on finishing all the things that I'm starting this year because that earns me points for my team for Zombie Knit Apocalypse, right? So that's sort of an aside, but that was one of the classes that I took. Okay, so I get there Wednesday. I go to Hill Country Weavers. I stop in, say hello to everybody. I actually got to see Suzanne there. I met Carson Demers, who was one of the teachers. He had just flown in and was visiting the shop for a little bit before heading up to the retreat. The retreat was held at the Horseshoe Bay Resort, which is about an hour away from Austin, kind of northwest-ish, north-northwest. Beautiful location, amazing, amazing facilities for this retreat. It's just stunning there. It's a kind of a golf resort, and they have wonderful meeting facilities. The food is excellent. We have dinner at the yacht club on Saturday night, which is always fun. So I get up to the retreat on Wednesday, and I just get to visit and hang out with the organizers and the teachers and some couple of the other early birds who get there on Wednesday. There's really just a handful of us. Then Thursday morning, I had a chance to interview Carson, Susan B. Anderson, and Bristol Ivy, as well as so those three were the teachers for the retreat. Ann Budd was also in attendance, playing the role of knit doctor and helping people with their knitting problems all weekend, which was fabulous. So she was the fourth person in the interview. And the fifth person was Christina, who is O Are They on Ravelry, she is one of the only five employees of Ravelry. And boy, what an amazing person to have a conversation with. She is brilliant, so super sweet, very talented, and so knowledgeable, obviously, about Ravelry. And to hear her perspective of the employee side and the computer programming side of that website, I mean, we are all here doing what we do, whether it's knitting, designing, most of us, because of Ravelry. So, and certainly interacting with each other because of Ravelry. So, like I said, it was just amazing to meet her. Excuse me. So that I got that interview, which will be coming up soon. Maybe the next up, not maybe the next episode of the podcast will be that interview. It's a little bit long, so it'll be a standalone. Yeah, so that was Thursday. Then the rest of the day, I just hung out. I got to shop at the marketplace, which was basically Hill Country Weavers Lite that they set up in the marketplace. It's amazing. The classes I took were Friday morning. I took the colorwork mitts. Friday afternoon, I took a short row class from Bristol Ivy, who is again brilliant, amazing, and I learned so much from that class. And then Saturday morning, I wasn't feeling very well. I think I had eaten something that I probably shouldn't have eaten, and then woke up sort of not feeling great. But then Saturday afternoon was my last class with Carson Demers, who is a brilliant mind. He is a physical therapist. His emphasis is in ergonomics, and he wants us to be able to knit for the rest of our lives. So he teaches you ergonomics for knitting and for life, and it's amazing, totally life-changing. I'm sitting here right now thinking Carson would be failing me. So that was Saturday. Then Saturday night, we had the big farewell dinner. Vicki Howell was the keynote speaker and also spoke were Suzanne, the owner of Hill Country Weavers, her sister and her niece spoke about her and just her legacy and being in the family with some with a creative mind and not really knowing, what she does. Neither one of them are knitters, and so to hear her stories, the story of her legacy as someone really on the outside of our industry looking in and just loving their sister and their aunt and appreciating what she does even though they can't do it. It was just a just endearing, hilarious time. It was so great. And I totally like Cindy, the organizer. I'm crying right now thinking about it. It was just so sweet. Cindy kept saying all weekend, "I have ocular incontinence," which I'm totally stealing that now because I absolutely have ocular incontinence. And I see someone crying and I start crying. I think about crying. Ooh, excuse me. I think about crying and I'm crying. Think about something poignant and I start crying. I just can't help it. Ocular incontinence is the best way to say that. Sorry for the water or the tea today because I'm just a little extra scratchy. So what y'all really want to see is all of the lovely things, right, that I got. So super cute swag bag. There are these woven kind of burlap woven bags, and they are waterproof. They have a like a coating on the inside, which is super great. Of course, we had our binders with all of our info. I don't even know where I'm gonna put all this stuff. We all got this really sweet bag made by Junie B. So Junie made these for us last year. This is my I like big balls and I cannot lie, which my boys are old enough to think is so hilarious because it's potty humor. But these, we all got this little Notions cute bag. Let's see, that's my classroom notes. One of my roommate, sweet Susan, gave me this little cutie that she made. Little Notions thing. Which it's always so nice to get sewn items from when you're a sewer that you didn't have to make. Okay, so in the swag bag, the theme of the swag bag was luxury this year, and so it was all about nice things and beautiful things. We all got these leather bracelets with the markings, the inch and centimeter markings. I have washed mine and let it dry on my skin, so it is kind of molding to me, and boy did that stink, but boy did it help soften it up super quick. We all got yarn bowls, beautiful yarn bowls. I think they're beautiful. I have a dark wood one, and so I love this lighter wood one to add to my collection. We all got a skein of the Uncommon Thread. This is in the Robin's Egg colorway, and it is 70% baby alpaca, 20% silk, 10% cashmere. So I'm hoping I can knit with this. It's so soft. I don't know if alpaca likes me or not yet. I really want alpaca to like me, but I don't know if it does. But regardless, it's a gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous skein of yarn. We got, we had a tea party one night. I totally won an entire tea set. But this is some tea from Tea Embassy that we all got after the tea party. We got some wool and cashmere shampoo from the Laundress. This is in the cedar scent. Which it's not open, so I can't smell it, but it's interesting to think about cedar being a scent to wash with. We got all of these little yarn samples from South Africa, from Sally from Over the Sea, Far Away. Sally is the host of the Wool Diaries podcast, if you are not familiar, so you need to go check her out. We all got these lovely stitch marker and shawl pin sets. So these are super fun. Oh my gosh, there's so much. We got this little, with post-its for notes and flags for bookmarks or, spot keepers or whatever, from Ann Budd, her Knit for Fun Retreats. Super great for a Notions pouch. And then I got this, I kind of hung out with the Shibui ladies. They have the area manager and then her boss for Shibui Shibui Knits is the name of the company, and they gave me these sample cards of all of their yarn bases. So I have a sample of all of Shibui. Isn't that gorgeous? So all the different blends, all the different yarns, just all of them, which is super cool. And the other cool thing is they gave me, so this explains what each base is, and then this side tells you if, like, this says C mixed with SC, which is Sema mixed with Silk Cloud, and if you do that, then it says your suggested gauge, your suggested needle size, and which patterns they have knit with those mixes. So as a reference, or to kind of give you a jumping off point if you're trying to decide, okay, I want to mix these two, but, you know, would that work in this shirt or in a shirt period or whatever. So it's such a really cool tool. So thank you so much to the ladies at Shibui. That was super fun. Let me load this stuff back in here. Again, this is probably my favorite thing, though. I think it was one of everybody's favorite things, these leather bracelets. So fun. And like I said, mine has worn in quite nicely. I could hardly get it on the first day, and now I can just take it on and off super easily, which is lovely. So the things that I purchased from the market, I purchased the Brooklyn Tweed earlier, before the retreat, but it was for the retreat. I purchased a couple of books. I got the new Pom Pom Quarterly, because Megan Fernandez, who's the editor, owner of editor-in-chief of Pom Pom Magazine, she is always at these retreats, and she's such a treasure. So fun to talk with. So I got the new issue of Pom Pom. I purchased this book. It's called Capsule. It's by Michelle Wang, and it is all Brooklyn Tweed yarns, gorgeous sweaters and hats and garments and amazing things. The photography is gorgeous, as is anything Brooklyn Tweed does. I have a hat in here that I know I'm gonna make, and then this sweater. Oh my gosh, right? It's called Bingham Pullover. Totally want to make that. I totally want to make this cardigan. I just really can't even stand it. This cardigan as well. This one is called Isla, I think. And I like it that it's really kind of bulky cardigan, but it's shorter, which is really cool for someone who has big hips because it would not add dimension to the hips. Let's say that. So anyway, beautiful book. Very excited about it. I purchased, oh, and then I got as a gift from Cindy, who's amazing, I got the new Interpretations 4. So excited. So I have a hard copy of this. The other super exciting thing is the last day they announced the teachers for next year, and the teachers for next year's retreat are Vera Valamaki, Hohi Locatelli, and Michelle Wang. So very, very, very excited about that. Yay! I hope I get in next year because it keeps getting bigger and harder to get in. So I'm crossing my fingers that I can get in to see those lovely ladies. Okay, so now I want to talk about the yarns and other little goodies that I got from the marketplace. I purchased, oh my gosh, I keep pulling out yarn that I forgot I got. This is kind of crazy. Oh, it's only 1 month before DFW. Y'all are gonna have to come buy all my bags, all my yarn. Okay. So, oh my gosh, I even forgot I got this. Okay, so wow, lots of wool piggery here, y'all. I purchased another skein of this soot. I showed you this earlier, and I know I'm gonna have some extra. And I purchased another skein to go with it because this is the color that the hat that I want to make out of that capsule book. So I have that. I purchased six skeins of Shibui linen to make a tank top. They had a fashion show one evening, and we got to be some of the first people to see the brand new Shibui garment patterns that are coming out in about maybe 2 or 3 weeks. I can't talk to you about them yet. I purchased one of the patterns, but I can't talk to you about it yet because it hasn't been released. But I will tell you that it's gonna be awesome. So awesome that I have to make it. And I bought some linen to make it. Now, this color, it's not really totally being, maybe that's kind of close. It's sort of a burgundy-ish wine color, kind of a brownish burgundy. More brown than red, maybe, I would say. It's called velvet. So it's sort of brown, burgundy, purple. Ish. So I have six skeins of that, which I think is more than I need, but I wanted to be sure that I had enough. I purchased this skein. Whoa, super bright. That's about how bright it is. This is one color that I don't have. It's called Pinky Swear, and I got that to add to my hedgehog stash. I got one skein of Madeline Tosh Vintage in the Dust Weaver colorway because it's like pinks and grays. And I love this base. And I have two other skeins of Vintage. And I have this, my eye on a particular shawl that I'd like to knit with those three colors. So I got that. And then the last thing is I purchased, I'm gonna have to see if I can find the pattern. I purchased three skeins of Camellia fiber. Man, let's just blow in that out. There we go. And this color is, that's actually not that bad. It's sort of a, it's called pomegranate, and it's just a pinky red. I really tried to not get this color. I tried so hard. This is a sport weight base, 100% merino wool, 325 yards. I've never tried their yarn before, but it's so, look at that. It looks just so springy and lovely. I am not typically a sport weight yarn. I'm not drawn to it, but I bought it specifically for one of the new patterns in Interpretations 4. And it is by Vera. Let's see if I can find it. Yes, it's called Tourmaline. So it's this cowl. It's big, chunky cables. And it looks like, oh wow, without showing the pattern, you can wear it long or short, like she had it on that previous page. So I think it's beautiful, and that's totally my style of things to wear. So I got that. Before I left, I had ordered this skein from Loopy-U. This just happened to come in while I was gone. It's this dark gray, almost black skein of Volmize. And I got this because I have two skeins of Volmize in my stash that I have not used. I've had them there forever, but it's because they don't go together. And I'm sort of paralyzed with what to do with them. But I got this because one of the colors is like a mustardy honey color, which I think a gray black would be beautiful with. So I got that, and I think now I'll be able to use them together. And right down the street from the retreat is a lovely little yarn store called Nan's Needleworks. And on the way out, I visited that shop, and come to find out, she had offered up 25% off to anyone coming from the retreat, which is a fabulous deal. So I took her up on that little discount and got some sock yarn. Surprise! I purchased this because I've never seen it before, and boy, if I can knit up big old chunky socks, right? This is 70% superwash wool, 30% nylon. It's Viking of Norway, Viking Ragan. The colors look totally me. Purples and mauves and grays. And it looks like it's like a DK or worsted weight. I would say probably worsted weight. 250 yards. Yeah, so, and it's got nylon in it. It's very, it does feel a little acrylicky, just. You start getting more nylon, and it's, you know, it definitely has that not all wool feel, but shoot, maybe I'll make some slippers or something with this. I think that would be great. So I got that. I got a skein of the Cascade Heritage Prints in that Christmas color that everybody seems to have, and I've almost bought about 12 times and just haven't. So, you know, this is $12.95 at 25% off. Can't beat that, right? So I got that one. And then the last skein that I got is a skein of Noro Tayo. And I would love to knit. You can see the colors inside are some brighter pinks and like some greens. Yeah, super fun. Super, super, super fun. I would love to knit some of those like alternating stripe Noro socks. Just love them. So, got that again for 25% off. You can't beat it. So, that's all the yarn. Oh my gosh, so much. So that is it for Hello Lovelies. That's my recap of the event. I have to say thank you so much to Suzanne for having the retreat and for having me as a podcaster, interviewer, person there. It was amazing. Thank you to Cindy for everything. You're amazing. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much to Carson Demers, Susan B. Anderson, and Bristol Ivy for being amazing teachers. I learned something in each and every class that I took, whether it was a new skill or whether it was a new way to knit ergonomically, to save my back, to save my arms and hands. It was just a lovely weekend. And of course, hanging out with friends is amazing. So I think that is it for this week. I am gonna go back to sewing all the things for DFW, and I will see you next time. Bye, guys.